Okay, so finite element method is ada orang mesti kalau rakam tadi boleh viralkan kan? Baik. Okay, finite element method FEM is used to numerically solve PDEs. Okay, so kita ada dua benda kat sini. Okay? So kita ada ODE. So ODE yang korang dah buat hari tu dalam MATLAB. Dan kita juga ada PDE. So PDE, the full name is partial differential equation. So dalam ODE kita ada satu variable je kita nak solve, like for example dA dt ke. But in PDE we have more than one variable to be solved, meaning that the equation is differentiated with respect to more than one variable. Like ODE, kita ada differentiation about t, okay, with respect to t. But in PDE, we have maybe dA dt, and also we have dA dx, for example. So at the time, dengan ada x, x ni dia differentiation about the space, okay. Space maksudnya ialah kalau dalam geometri ni, so dalam geometri ni dia ada space, ada ruang dia, ada volume, for example dalam geometri yang dalam gambar ni, in this figures. So we are solving the equation about the geometry or about the space in the geometry. Dengan time lah kita solve dia with respect to time. Kalau dia berubah dengan masa, macam mana dia punya solutions. Okay, so FEM usually used for PDEs, okay? When you have equation with differentiation with respect to more than one variable. So one advantage of FEM over finite difference method or other methods is that the geometries can be discretized. Maksudnya discretized tu yang can be mesh. So you can use geometry in any shape that you want. Okay, macam jantung ni, dia punya bentuk macam complicated. So kalau guna method yang dalam MATLAB, maybe susah sikit. Sebab geometry dia macam sekejap dia gelembung sini, sekejap macam bergerigi. So nak mesh tu susah, okay? I mean nak solve dia guna MATLAB susah. So kalau guna FEM, we can mesh this easily, okay? And solve using meshing, yeah. So this is very useful for biomedical application because our organs or tissue has complex structure. So jantung, our lungs, our aorta here, the structures are very very complex. So using finite element method is the most efficient lah. So the advantages of FEM, you can handle irregular domains or irregular geometry, and more memory efficient. Okay? Memory efficient maksudnya bila nak solve pakai komputer, dia guna less RAM. Okay? However, kita kena mesh. So to mesh is one of a problem in finite element. Okay? Sebab nak mesh tu kadang-kadang ada error, for example. So the basic step for FEM is that first you must have your PDE or the equation that you want to solve, and you must have your boundary condition. So BC here is boundary condition, and also you must have your geometry, what geometry you are going to use. So dalam finite element software, they automatically use here we call it weak formulation. Kalau belajar dalam kelas finite element, maybe lah pernah dengar like Galerkin method, tak tahulah pernah dengar ke tak. And then we have meshing and basis function, and then from there kita solve dia dalam matrix. Okay, so dalam kelas finite element korang punya matrix macam besar, like 8x8 lah, 9x9, that one is basically because dia susun equation tu dalam because there are so many mesh, so each mesh ada equation dia. So when you combine all the equation together, it becomes a set of equation, okay? A system of equation. After you solve the matrix, you get some solution, and then you can proceed for post-processing, like plot graph, maybe plot pressure, for example, or maybe you can plot a graph something versus time, for example. So the steps are similar for all finite element method problems. Kena ada ada geometry, ada equation, ada boundary condition, and then kita kena mesh. And then like weak form and matrix equation ni selalunya dalam software dia akan buatkan, so kita tak perlu risau. After you solve, then you go to for post processing ni, nak plot graph ke apa-apa. So again, so first you need to discretize the structure or the geometry, and then select proper interpolation model. So dalam software selalunya yang ni dia by default, okay? Kita dia dah set by default buat interpolation model to use. Interpolation model ni yang basis function tadi. And then derivation of element stiffness matrix, yang ni pun automatically dalam software, so kita tak payah kira by hand lah. And then assemble the element equations, ni semua dalam software buat. And then obtain the solution at nodal displacement. And then lastly, you can compute maybe the strain, stress, or anything like fluid velocity, pressure, and so on. So ni a little bit of introduction. So and then we discretize the structure. So discretize the structure meaning that we mesh the geometry. So this is the original geometry, for example, and then we mesh it. Okay. So bila mesh dia punya geometry tu jadi tak smooth lah. So to make the geometry smooth, you need to use a smaller mesh, or what we call finer mesh, okay? Finer mesh or fine mesh. Tapi bila guna finer mesh, kita akan guna more RAM, okay? So kalau komputer yang ada 2 gig RAM je, memang lembab lah. So kena guna komputer yang dekat lab yang finite element tu. And then different methods of dividing the domain. Ya, anda nak tanya?
Ada yang tak masuk.
Ya, siapa nak tanya?
Ada yang tak masuk.
Ada member tak masuk lagi kelas lagi.
Cepat suara kat AM tadi.
Itulah, aduh, tiba. Zaim. Tiba. Okay, dah masuk dah? Saya masuklah, tengok rakaman je lah. Okay, so the reason why we mesh the geometry, because kalau kita nak solve equation tu dekat geometry besar macam ni, dia jadi macam tak accurate lah kalau guna finite element. So kita meshkan dia supaya kita solve dekat setiap mesh ni, kita solve equation tu. So kalau ada 1000 mesh, meaning that ada 1000 equation, okay? 1000 mesh means 1000 equation. So that's why you solve a matrix, okay? Kalau nak solve manually, jadi lambat lah. So that's why kita guna software. So yang macam belajar dalam kelas finite element tu, sebenarnya bullshit lah juga, kan? Tapi dia nak introduce to you the theory, the concept of finite element. So sebenarnya finite element ni dah jarang dah orang guna manual. Macam tak logik je nak guna manual. So selalunya orang guna software je, okay? And then mesh ada banyak jenis, okay? Ada banyak bentuk mesh. So usually we use triangular and tetrahedral mesh. And then there are variety of mesh that has different number of nodes, okay? Like for triangle here, ada 3 nodes. Ni yang titik ni nodes lah. And then sometimes you can have nodes in between the nodes, or in between the lines or the edge of the mesh. So for solid mechanics, usually we use 10 node tetrahedral. I think same for other simulation like fluid dynamics, also use 10 node tetrahedral. But sometimes we can also use like rectangular or quadrilateral mesh, But ni different case lah, okay. Tak tahu, ada tujuan dia. Tapi yang selalu guna tetrahedral then and triangle mesh, 2D mesh. And then after we mesh, so kalau kita mesh ni, kita tahu kita akan dapat solution at each node, okay? After we solve the finite element. But how about the solution in between the nodes? So dekat antara nodes ni pun kena ada solution juga. So to obtain the solution in between the nodes, we use interpolation models. So dalam software finite element, already have the interpolation models. So you don't need to worry to calculate, okay, to define the interpolation model. So usually by default, I think it will use Lagrange shape function. But you can always change the shape function, maybe to obtain a more accurate results. Okay, selalunya yang tukar shape function ni, maybe yang high level punya orang lah. Okay, saya pun jarang guna shape function yang lain. Selalunya Lagrange je. And then after that, each node will have its own equation. And then all equations or all nodes are solved simultaneously. So you use matrix form. So belajar dalam numerical method, kita guna like Gauss elimination, for example. Software finite element pun guna method yang macam tu juga, Gauss elimination, Cramer's rule code, tak tahulah. Tapi dia orang ada method lain lagi dalam tu yang dah tak payah belajar, okay? Yang tak payah tahu, okay? Maybe kalau korang minat nak tahu lebih lanjut, kena buka Wikipedia. Okay, after that we can set the physics, okay? What kind of physics that you want to use? For example, like fluid dynamics. Untuk study fluid, siapa yang ambil CFD maybe guna fluid lah. And then solid mechanics. So solid mechanics mostly belajar dalam kelas finite element. And then heat transfer, subject heat transfer tak tahu, tak guna finite element kot. So commonly ada tiga physics lah. And also there are many many more physics, okay, that we can use. And then we need to set the material properties for the geometry. Dia metal ke, dia wood or human tissue, blood for example. And then we set the boundary conditions. So bila ada finite element, kita ada boundary conditions. And then we mesh, we solve, and then we get the results. Okay, so kita dah masuk the first physics, okay? So the first physics that we are going to learn in this class is diffusion equation. Okay, so diffusion equation usually used to describe the behavior of motion, collective motion of particles, microparticles in a material resulting from random movement. Okay, so kita ada particles, maybe kita nak tengok dia punya pergerakan dia dalam ruang, maybe dalam bilik ke, or dalam badan kita, maybe kita nak tengok pergerakan ions ke in our body. So we use diffusion equation. Okay, so diffusion equation has this form of equation, del phi del t equals del dot d times del phi. Okay, benda lah pula ni. Okay, so kita ada simbol ni. Simbol ni bermaksud del over del x I plus del over del y j plus del over del z k. So kalau still remember vector, tak tahulah belajar dekat matrix ataupun maths ke, kita ada vector I, j, k. So 3D lah, kalau 3D I, j, k. Kalau 2D I dengan j je. Kalau 1D I saja. So each of the vector is with respect to differentiation on the x axis, y axis and z axis. So yang triangle ni adalah benda ni, So if you look here, your equation has del t, one variable, and then the other variable is in terms of del x, del y, and del z. So x, y, and z here represent your space, okay? Or geometry, ruang mana nak solve finite element or diffusion equation. So here, because you have del t and del x, so we have to use partial differential equation, okay? Or finite element method. And then d kat sini is a constant or coefficient. So we call this diffusion coefficient. And then r is the location, and phi here is the density or the amount of diffusing material. So yang ni nampak complicated. So in general form, we write like this, okay? Del phi del t plus del dot tau. So tau ni represent this thing lah. Tapi kita tengok lagi nanti. Okay, jangan risau, subjek ni tak ada maths. Okay, so there are many application for diffusion equation. So the most common application of diffusion equation is in heat equation or heat transfer. You also have diffusion equation in mass transfer. So dalam biomedical engineering, it's very common, commonly used in electrical propagation model. So siapa yang buat FYP dengan Dr. Jamil tu, yang buat electrical propagation dalam jantung tu, dia akan guna diffusion model. And then we have water permeability in porous media and so on. Okay? Ada banyak dia punya application. So ini example of application in heat equation. Tak penting pun, just nak tunjuk dia guna PDE ni. Tu je, okay. Maybe dalam kelas Dr. Sudaka ke belajar kot. Atau Dr. Adam ke Dr. Wan Azmi, mana-mana lah. Okay, dalam mass transfer pun kita ada belajar, ada guna diffusion equation kat sini. So manalah tahu tiba-tiba siapa yang buat FYP yang related with mass transfer, kena buat finite element, kena guna finite element on mass transfer equation. Okay, so now kita akan masuk macam mana nak guna COMSOL untuk solve diffusion equation. Okay, so bolehlah kot buka COMSOL. So kita akan guna tutorial yang saya bagi dalam WhatsApp group tadi, okay? Oh, lembabnya. Cepatlah buka. Okay, so before we go to COMSOL, so in COMSOL we have diffusion equation, but it use the physics called general form PDE. Okay, so siapa yang tak familiar COMSOL lagi? Okay, jap. Okay, maybe kita start tutorial terus kot. Okay, kita buat yang tutorial that I give to you, okay? Okay, so in this tutorial, we are going to simulate the electrical signals in the heart, okay? In a heart. So, dalam jantung kita ada there is electrical signal that cause the heart to pump, okay? Kalau belajar masa form 3, kita ada belajar pasal jantung kita ada SA note, tak tahu ingat tak, SA note, AV note. Okay, so sebelum yang siapa-siapa yang masuk sekolah sekolah teknik, form T dah belajar, okay? Jangan nak tipu lah. So mungkin ingat-ingat lupa. So jantung kita ada electrical signal. So kalau biasa dengar ada orang yang sakit jantung kena pakai pacemaker, kena pakai some implant dalam jantung. Pacemaker we call it. So pacemaker ni dia nak bantu jantung tu hasilkan electrical signal. Okay? Sebab maybe jantung dia lemah, tak boleh nak hasilkan electrical signal. Okay, so we can model that the electrical signal in the heart using finite element. So in modeling the electrical signal, we use a diffusion model, or we call the model as Fizhou-Nagumo model. Okay. So ni nama je, okay? Fizhou-Nagumo model. So in this tutorial, first we will learn on how to use COMSOL to draw to draw a geometry in COMSOL. So here it represents the heart which has two chamber, heart that has two chambers, okay? So it use some semi-spherical shape, okay? And then the electrical signal is represented by Fizhou-Nagumo equations. So there are two PDE in this Fizhou-Nagumo equation. So you have del U1 del T, and the second PDE is del U2 del T. So U1 here represent the action potential. Action potential ataupun yang kita belajar masa lecture 2 hari tu, setiap neuron hasilkan action potential, okay? So that action potential also generated in our heart, okay? And also U2 here is a gate variable. So bila dah hasilkan action potential, some cells dalam jantung dia tak boleh hasilkan action potential lagi. Dia kena tunggu satu tempoh bertenang dulu baru boleh hasilkan another action potential. So that's the nature of our body. Once dah hasilkan action potential, untuk hasilkan the next action potential, dia kena ada tempoh bertenang dulu. So the tempoh bertenang we call the resting potential or the resting state, okay? So in this equation we have parameters alpha, epsilon, beta, gamma, del, okay? All of this has its own value, okay? And then in this example, dia akan guna boundary condition U1 insulating using the assumption that no current is flowing into or out of the heart. So ni salah satu boundary condition yang dalam yang digunakan, okay? Meaning that dalam jantung tu tak boleh ada suddenly ada external current can come into the jantung, okay? Or the current generated in the heart can go out of the heart, okay? So ini one of the assumption. And then one of the boundary condition. And then after that, it use initial condition, define the initial potential distribution U1, where one quadrant of the heart is at constant. Ni apa benda ni saya tak faham. But basically, use this true and false statement here. Okay, jangan risau. Ni kita tengok je tutorial ni dia buat macam mana. Okay, so in this tutorial, there are two simulations, two different simulation. First, you use Fizhou-Nagumo, and secondly, you will use Landau-Ginzburg equation. But for this class, I'm going to show you the first equation only, Fizhou-Nagumo. Okay. So nanti bila dah simulate, kita akan dapat result yang macam ni yang lebih kurang. So yang merah ni, the electrical signal, dia akan spread throughout the heart, okay? So dekat time 120, signal tu baru nak generate maybe at time 500, signal tu dah spread, okay? Spread maybe half of the heart already. So Landau-Ginzburg punya result dia pelik sikit, okay? Rasanya sepatutnya dia ada mention yang Landau-Ginzburg ni, Landau-Ginzburg equation ni takes more RAM untuk solve, okay? So kalau komputer yang ada sikit RAM, maybe dia makan masa sikit lah nak solve. So when attempting these types of large models, we strongly recommend use 64-bit. Okay, 64-bit, tak ada apa-apa. Okay, dia dah buang statement tu. Okay, sepatutnya dia makan banyak RAM untuk Fizu Nagumo, untuk Landau-Ginzburg. So kita guna Fizu Nagumo. Fizu Nagumo sikit je, 1 gig kot, 2 gig. Okay, so just follow the instruction, okay? Okay, first, when you open console, then you can click the model wizard. Okay, so always start with model wizard. So just click. And then here, it says click 3D. So kita punya model tadi 3D. And then kita pilih physics, okay? So for physics, we are choosing general form PDE. So you can search general form PDE. It's here. And kalau dah biasa guna console, tak nak search pun boleh. Boleh cari dekat dalam yang physics yang dia beri. So general form PDE is in mathematics, okay? Mathematics PDE interface. So general form PDE here. So it says the add ni. And then in the number of dependent variables, type 2. So kita ada 2 equation. So kita guna 2 general form PDE lah basically. So you have U1 and U2 in your general form PDE. So when you type 2 here, meaning that your physics here has 2 equations, okay? And then click study. So choose time dependent, okay? So kita punya model berubah dengan masa. So it's a time dependent study. So usually you have 2 types of study. Either stationary study. Stationary means you are solving things that is does not dependent with time. And second study is time dependent or dynamic study, okay? So we choose time dependent. Okay, so when you double click, dia akan finish, or you can press and then click done. Okay, sama juga. Dia akan keluar benda ni. So dalam console ada 3 column here. So you have this column, we call this model builder column. So model builder ni lah korang nak set apa semua dalam model builder. And then we have the settings column. So setting ni korang input like equation ke dalam settings, okay? And then we have the graphic. So graphic ni adalah tempat bila korang lukis nanti dia akan keluar gambar kat sini, okay? And then yang bawah ni basically bila dah solve nanti dia akan keluar sama ada simulation to fail ke ataupun basically the details on the simulation, whether how long it will take, how long it takes to solve the simulation, it will come up here, down here. Okay, so in the root, dekat toren ni, so go to the model builder window, model builder, click the root node name dia, nantilah. In the root node setting window, locate the unit system, I think here it's good. And then go here locate the unit and system. So dekat sini, okay. So unit system dekat setting window. And then change to none, okay. So kita solve the PDE that has no unit, okay. Kita tak nak ada unit sebab dalam case, dalam tutorial ni, dia akan jadi complicated bila ada unit. So we remove the unit. The equation in this model are given in dimensionless. Dimensionless mean no units, okay? Turning off unit support avoids warning. So kalau kita ada unit, bila kita lupa nak tutup dia, dia akan keluar warning nanti bila nak nak setting. So that's why dia tutup, okay? Dia tutup unit tu jadi none. Okay, so we start by drawing the geometry. Okay, so first we draw the heart, okay? Okay, so here kita nak lukis sphere. So you can choose sphere by going to this tab on top here, geometry. And then maybe in primitive. So you have sphere here, okay? So just click. And then after that, dia kata locate the size section. So size kat sini. In the setting, and then radius 54, so tukar 54, and then build selected. So kita akan keluar sphere kat sini, okay, ni graphic window lah, okay. And then we draw ellipse, so same, under primitive, more primitive, ellipsoid, okay, and then locate the size and shape, and then fill in this, okay, these values. So A axis 54, B and C, and then build selected. Okay, so you have two geometry yang bertindan. So you can view the inner geometry, which is the sphere just now, by clicking yang ni kot, transparency. So dia ada dua geometri kat situ. Sphere kat dalam, ellipse kat luar. So dia punya jantung tadi, bentuk dia macam egg shape. So kita kena do something by removing some part of the geometry to make it to look like an egg shape, okay? So after that, we want to remove part of the geometry by using Boolean operation. Okay. So to use Boolean operation, first you need to draw the block. Okay. Draw block under primitive block, and then just fill in the values given. And then position. Tukar kepada center, base kepada center, and then Z field type 55, so 55, it's selected. So here dia nak remove bahagian atas supaya nampak macam bentuk telur nanti. Okay, so to remove we use difference. So in the Boolean operation here, choose difference, and then select the object ELP or ellipse one only. So ellipse. So just click the ellipse. And then in the difference, locate the difference section. In the subtract section, activate. And then select the block BLK one. You just click dekat block ni. And then build selected. Okay, so dah hilang kawasan atas tadi. So tinggal sphere je. Yang bawah ni yang ellipse tadi. Okay, repeat the process. Kita nak remove yang bawah pula, yang sphere bawah. So you can go back to primitive block. And then -55. It's selected. Oh, center ni tukar center. And then same thing, go to Boolean and partition, pilih difference. And then in the object to add, choose sphere. Object to subtract, pilih block. Bit selected, okay. So dapatlah bentuk A. And then union, go to Boolean and partition, union. And then dia kata pilih semua object by pressing Ctrl A. So tekan Ctrl A. And then build all object. Okay, itu je. And then scale. So dia nak buat the inner cavity pula. So yang ni outside cavity je, kita nak buat the inner cavity. So to create the inner cavity, we need to scale macam extrude lah lebih kurang. So kita nak extrude dia ke dalam. Okay, so click transform, scale. In the input section, press select keep input object. And then dekat ruang ni, just press the whole geometry, uni 1, okay. And then locate the scale factor section, scale factor sini. Type 2/3, so 2/3. Get selected. So you scale the outer geometry so that it forms the inner cavity, eh? Ataupun extrude ke dalam lah. And then ulang balik difference, but dia nak buang yang dalam ni. So go to partition, difference, select uni 1. And then in the object to subtract, select scale 1. So untuk select scale 1, you can either right here, click the paste selection here, and then type scale 1, okay. Or the other way is you can go to the geometry and then just scroll, okay. Bila scroll, dia akan pergi ke kawasan dalam geometry tu. So kita nak yang dalam ni. Okay, so ada dua cara, boleh tulis kat sini dengan scroll je. And then build selected. So dia dah removekan yang dalam tu, okay. And then kita nak buat dinding, the wall that separates the two chamber, the inner chamber. So first, draw cylinder. So primitive, cylinder. Oh, geometri saja nak makan setengah jam. 45, 10, okay. And then negative 5. Set 185. Cartesian. Okay, so kita buat satu cylinder that divides the heart into two chamber. And then union. Ctrl A. And then keep interior boundary. Clear kan? And then build all object. Okay, so dia dah hasilkan dua chamber kat sini. Terus, okay, so jantung ni ada dua chamber, chamber left and chamber right, okay. So dalam test nanti, geometri tak adalah se-complicated ni, geometri simple je. Maybe kena boolean sikit-sikit je, okay. Yang ni dia banyak step, okay. So jangan risau pasal geometri yang pelik-pelik ni, okay. Geometri selalu empat segi je, bulat, macam tu je, okay. Okay, so kita barulah start dia punya nak setting untuk simulation. So firstly, to set the simulation, we must define the parameters. So to define the parameters, we go to global definition here, and then click parameters 1 here. So kita ada table kat sini. So just fill in the table with the name and expression column here, okay. So alpha 0.1, epsilon 0.1. Okay, after DICE, kita boleh pergi dekat general form PDE. Okay, pergi kat general form PDE sini. And then in the model builder window, expand. So expand tadi ditutup, so just expand. Then click general form PDE 1. Okay, pilih yang ni. In the setting window, locate the conservative flux, okay, conservative flux. Specify the second tau vector, okay, so kosongkan tau vector. And then locate the source term. Okay, type dia punya equation dia. Okay, so apa yang berlaku ni? So apa yang kita tulis dalam ni sebenarnya datang dari equation yang diberi dalam introduction tadi. Okay. So, bila dekat general form PDE ni, if you drop down the equation here, you will see some equation here, written here. So, this equation here is built-in console, okay? Built-in console equation. Okay, so dalam console, equation dia ialah dalam bentuk yang diberi, okay? So, in console, it's EA del square U del T plus dA del U del T plus del dot tau equals F. So apa yang kena buat dekat sini ialah kita comparekan balik equation ni dengan equation yang diberi dalam introduction ni. Okay, just compare, okay. So here EA del U del square U del T. Dekat sini tak ada del square U del T. So bila tak ada, kita letaklah EA ni kosong, okay. So EA by default dah memang kosong. Okay, meaning that there is no del square U del T in the equation given. And then the next equation in console is dA times del U del T. So dekat dua equation ni ada del U1 del T and del U2 del T. Meaning that ada equation yang ni, ada bahagian ni. So kita just gantikan dA. So kat sini dA equals 1 lah basically, okay. So we put by default dA is equal 1 here. And then we keep comparing. So the next one is del dot tau here. So in the first equation here we have triangle U here. So triangle U dalam ni bermaksud del square, del square U. So siapa yang familiar dengan division equation akan tahu del triangle U is del square U, okay. Maybe korang tak pernah tahulah, okay, ataupun tahu tapi lupa ke apa ke. And then in the second equation there is no triangle, okay. Meaning that del dot u, dot, dot tau here for the second equation is zero. So that's why you set zero for the second second part here. Okay. So the first part here is for u1. The second part here is for u2. Since u2 tak ada triangle, so dia punya tau equal zero. Okay. But for the first one, ada triangle u, so dia just leave it as it is. Okay, tak payah tukar. And then lastly is f here. So f ni yang the remaining things yang tak ada related dengan del square u or del del dot tau. So kalau tengok dalam equation ni, yang tak ada related is yang kat ujung ni. Okay. So you just rewrite this equation in terms of code here. So alpha minus u1 times u1 minus 1 times u1 minus 2 u2. And then for the second equation, it's epsilon times beta times u1 minus gamma times u2 minus delta. So just rewrite balik kat sini. So ada dua kolom ni, ada dua ruang ni, means the first space or the first ruang here is for the first equation. The second ruang is for the second equation. Okay. Okay, after that we set the initial condition. So initial condition is given in terms of true or false. So just copy je lah. Okay. So first, under the component 1, general form PDE, locate the initial values. And then in the U1 text field, tulis benda ni. So copy paste. And second one also copy paste. Letak dekat U2. Okay. So dah settle setting. Kita meshkan pula. So mesh, pergi dekat mesh. And then locate the mesh settings kat sini. Element size tukar kepada fine. And then bit all. Okay, dia nak mesh dia halus sikit, so dia letak fine. Okay. So kalau korang letak extremely fine, dia akan lagi halus. Tapi dia nak generate the mesh, it will take a lot of RAM. Okay. So siapa yang berani tekan extremely fine, cubalah. Okay. Saya pun tak tahu komputer saya hebat tak. Kalau tak nak tekan, takut. Okay, and then after you mesh, then we can go to study one and solve the model. Okay, so study one. Under the study one, go to time dependent here. Step one, time dependent. And then we set the time range. Okay, so time range is given macam ni. Okay. So the meaning of this time range is that it start from zero, increase by 5 until 500. Okay, so they start dari zero, increase 5 until 500. So after you set the time range, then you can click compute. Okay, compute ni maksudnya solve the model. So compute. So kita boleh tengok dia solve the model. Ooh, jam. Yeah. Okay, bila kita klik solve tadi, klik compute, dia akan ada green bar here. So yang ni menggambarkan model tu
tengah solving lah, dah nak solve ke belum. Okay, kalau buka dekat progress ni, dia akan tunjuk berapa percentage model tu dah solve. So baru 40%. Dekat log pula, dia senaraikan dia punya time step dan juga dia punya error, okay? Berapa banyak error, berapa banyak berapa banyak iteration yang digunakan, okay? So selalunya yang dekat log ni saya akan tengok bila saya nak tahu model ni boleh solve ke tak, okay? Selalunya orang yang buat maybe FYP ke, maybe the same thing dekat software lain pun ada benda-benda ni juga. Maybe boleh tengok model tu punya error berapa, okay? Tapi mostly untuk kelas ni kita nak tengok dia solve je, okay? Kita tak tak analyse all this progress and log. Okay, dia makan masa lama juga, dalam 2 minit, right? Okay, after that solve, kita akan dapat something. Okay, so we can go to the tutorial and plot some results, okay? So the default plot shows a slice plot. So ni slice plot, okay? Of the dependent variable. So ni slice plot of U1. So to create plot given in figure 2, dalam soalan tadi, figure 2. Nak create yang ni. You need to suppress some of the boundaries. Alhamdulillah. Expand the results. So dekat sini, dekat result. Then click study 1. Solution 1, data set. Study 1, solution 1. Click selection. Oh, kat atas ni. Okay, kat mana nak cari? Okay, data set, attribute, selection. Okay, you can also right click dekat study 1 ni and choose selection, okay? Dah keluar dah kat sini. Locate the geometric entity selection, choose boundary, paste selection. So type 1, 3, 10, 18. Okay. And then results, right click, 3D plot. Okay. And then after that, in the plot setting, plot data set edges, clear again. Surface 1, right click, choose surface. In the plot toolbar, click plot. Okay, so dapat result yang macam dalam sample tadi. Okay, apa yang dia buat tadi ialah yang selection apa semua tu, dia just nak remove some part of the geometry so that you can see the inner side, okay? The inner part of the geometry, the results in the inner heart, okay? And then click the transparency button. Okay. Locate the data section. Okay. Time. Oh. 120. Click plot. Okay, ni dekat time 120. Okay, so you can change the time here on the 3D plot group too. So basically untuk plot result, you just right click results here and then you can choose what kind of results that you want to plot. Okay, so usually 3D plot lah, okay, 3D plot. Then bila click 3D plot, kita boleh further right click and then choose what sort of results that you want to display. So in this example, it plots for the surface, okay? Dia plot result dekat surface saja. And then on the surface, the tutorial wants to show the value of U1, okay? So the action potential U1. And then click plot, dia akan keluar result dekat dalam grafik ni. And then you can change the time in the time when dekat 3D plot atas ni, okay? And then just change the time to whatever time that you want. For example 500, kita akan dapat macam ni, okay? Okay, dah habis untuk part 1 tutorial. So nanti kalau rajin try lah buat yang Landau-Ginzburg ni pula, okay? It might take some time to solve, but maybe you can learn on how to set, okay? Maybe familiarize yourself with COMSOL. Kalau dalam test selalunya tak adalah lukis geometri yang susah, lukis geometri yang simple je. Maybe susah dekat nak setting boundary condition ni. Okay? Boundary condition maybe korang pun tak faham apa benda lah boundary condition. Itu yang susah. And then after that nak plot something, you need to explore more on the plot, okay? Maybe kita boleh try plot something else like streamline for example. Disable kan dulu. And then maybe plot streamline. So ada warning tak boleh. So tak boleh, boleh try explore benda lain pula. Contour ke. Okay, dapatlah something. So maybe dalam test soalan suruh plot the contour plot of U1 for example. So try lah, try every single thing yang ada kat sini. Arrow line ke, particle trajectories ke. Kalau ada warning tak apalah, maknanya tak boleh plot, okay. Macam tadi ada warning, meaning that dia tak boleh plot untuk benda tu. Tapi contour plot boleh plot. So what else ada isosurface? So as we go along this course later, saya akan explain more when we do more tutorials, maybe I will explain what are the plots that we are using, okay? Like here, kita use surface. So basically surface, they just plot on the surface only, okay? Okay, so that's it for today's class. Any question before we end the lecture?
Doctor?
Yep.
This one ada juga console eh?
Tak ada. So to value RAM. Oh. Tak ada console. Test one MATLAB je. Yang macam assignment dengan exercise yang kita buat.
Okay.
So to value RAM guna ke? Sebelah green bar, yes. Yang tadi bila run tu, kita ada keluar kat sini, ni RAM lah. So dia guna virtual memory 1.4 GB. Physical memory maybe dia punya RAM. So RAM yang dia guna 1.2 GB je. Virtual memory ni apa lah? Entah. Siapa pandai komputer? Mungkin lebih mahir. Okay, any more question?
No sir.
No, apa? Gempak Luqman. Dah ada komsul dah Luqman?
Sudah saya, Alhamdulillah. Kimi membantu.
Alhamdulillah. Bagus lah Kimi. Orang Kedah. Hidup Kedah tiba.
Okay, so if you have okay, if you have any more questions, WhatsApp, okay? Kan test hari Jumaat kan itu kata. Test hari Jumaat. Hari Khamis kita akan discuss assignment 2, okay, 2B.
Okay. 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 Submission dekat kalam tu assignment 2A saja ke 2A 2B sekali?
Campur sekali tapi try compile zip file ke. Label lah label ni 2A 2B ke. Submit kat email kan, ada orang tu.
Jangan diintik je.
Nak bagi masa ke tak nak lah, alamak tak tahulah.
Aduh.
Okay, so that's it for today's class. So see you guys next week, okay? Assalamualaikum.
Assalamualaikum.